I'm all about the good vibes, the good vibes. We bout to have a good time. Leave my problems all behind, all behind. We living out the good life, yeah. I ain't gotta worry about a thing.
Oh no.
Had some obstacles I overcame.
Oh yeah.
You don't have to ever be the same.
Oh no.
Cause when we change the mind, we change the game.
Yo, 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 what's going on, everybody? It's your boy Kenny Clutch with another episode on the Clutch Vision Podcast. Yes, yes, I'm back. Sorry, guys, for the wait. I know I've been getting hit up the past couple weeks when the next podcast is dropping. I've been sick, guys. I've been sick. Brother had the flu. You know, I got four kids in the house, so you know what I'm saying? Like, they probably go to school, somebody bringing something home. Alright, so the whole family been under the weather the past 2 weeks. So it's been a little rough to the start of the year as far as health goes. But at least we got our health, right? At least we got our health. So we appreciate you. Appreciate you rocking with your boy Kenny Clutch. Alright, so listen, man. We got a lot to talk about. Before we do that, make sure you like, subscribe, comment on this video, share this video with your family, your friends. It's gonna be a good one. We about to get it in, you know what I'm saying? We might touch some people today, you know what I'm saying? And hopefully it's for the best. You know, so again, like, subscribe, comment below, share this video with a family, your friend, whoever it is. Donate to this podcast. The donate link will be in the description below, so make sure y'all go ahead and donate to the podcast, and let's keep this thing rolling, let's keep this thing moving, let's keep it, you know, elevating to the next level, to the next level, to the next level. So guys, man, listen, man, I hope everybody has had a good start to the new year. Right now it's January 25th, we're 25 days into the new year, 25 days in, and a lot's been going on. And today I want to touch on something that's near and dear to my heart. I want to shout out Fathers_Leading_Families. I want to shout him out, man. My dude up in North Jersey. So make sure y'all go ahead and check him out on Instagram. Fathers_Leading_Families on Instagram. Make sure you go check him out. Alright, he's got an awesome page for fathers, and that's what we're talking about today, y'all. We're talking about the pops. You know what, we're not even going to talk about just the pops, we're going to talk about the men, period. That's what we're going to talk about. We're going to talk about the men, we're going to address the men. And the reason why we're addressing the men is because we're the leaders. All right. Let's get that out the way. All right. When men were created, men are naturally born leaders. And our women, don't take this the wrong way, ladies. The women are there to help us along the way, to keep things in order. That's why they're more organized than we are most of the time. They're natural mothers. The female species, they take care. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? So I've been getting messages from a lot of women over the past couple months, and I'm not going to say no names or nothing like that, but where they've been having issues inside their home with their significant other, with their spouse or their boyfriend. And this one story stuck out to me, where there was a woman who's been dating, or not dating, she's been married to, you know, to her husband for years, and, you know, he stepped out on the marriage, and then they were separated, they got back together, but in between that separation, you know, he was still dealing with this other chick. And he ended up having another baby by the other chick. And his wife, this is how you know she a godly woman, his wife still forgave. Now that's strong. That's strong. Still forgave him. Still praying for him. See, the problem is that a lot of us men, we take that for granted. We take women like that, we take them for granted. You know what I'm saying? Because it's women like that that we want. It's women like that that we always want to have on the back burner. And vice versa. It's men like that that, you know, women want later in life when they're done doing what they want to do. When they're done doing, you know what I'm saying, their dirt. And men as well. See what we do is we go ahead and we want to play around. We're not done with our childish ways. Even though you're a grown man or woman. You know what I'm saying? You're a grown man and you're not done with your childish ways. And you got kids. How are you not done with your childish ways and you still have kids? I don't get it. How do you make babies and you acting like a baby? How do you make kids and you still acting like a kid? Let's talk about it. Now let's be fair. I'm not speaking on every man, but if this pertains to you, you know who you are. You know what I'm saying? If you know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, I'm not, man, don't hit my DM and be like, yo man, you don't even know what she be doing and that. Don't do that. Okay? Because listen, we speaking generally, right? And I'm speaking from a standpoint of love. Because at the end of the day, here's the deal. Ain't nobody telling you that you're wrong. You probably think for a second that this is the way to go. And why? Why do we think that? Because number one, most black men, you know what I'm saying? Well, it really don't even matter what race. Like, the father's not in their life. So who's there to guide them? The street? The streets probably ain't got no fathers in their lives. So what kind of example is that? Right? Right? So how do we have we don't even have an example. We ain't even got a template. We just sitting there going off the cuff. Yo, my mama raised me. Right? And then that's it. Your uncle's here, your uncle's there, in and out. There's no consistency. So listen, I'm not coming at you. I'm here to help and guide you from the knowledge and experiences that I know as your brother. Chill. The reason why is because I'm the one that's getting these DMs or whatever from these women that are going through it. Because, yeah, they see me with my son. They see me, you know, being a dad. With, you know, they see me being a husband, a father to all my kids and stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? And I show that. I show that to lead an example. I show that or whatever because I want other men to do the right thing. That ain't just for me. Yeah, I get pure joy out of it because I see other people being successful. It's about providing value, people. It's about providing value. I'm passionate about my family. I'm passionate about being a father because I want to provide value for others so that other men can see. Listen, man, if you ain't have a dad in your life, if you ain't have a father in your life, if you ain't have a man in your life to help lead you to be who to lead you to be the king that you are, I'm here to help you and I'm here to show you, along with a bunch of other dudes that's rocking with me. I'm not the only one. I'm not the only one. I'm just trying to use my following or whatever to, you know, to help and help you guide and push you to the next level. In case you needed that information, in case you needed to see, like, yo, hold up, what's up with? That's different. See, the problem is that we have this imagery. We have this imagery of what's shown on Instagram, on TV. You know what I'm saying? We have this imagery of, you know, even in the hip hop world, and I come from the hip hop world. You know what I'm saying? Whereas in there's you got rappers that got the Bentleys, they got the big houses, they got the girls, you know what I'm saying? They flashing the money, all of that. Y'all know that's a video, right? Y'all know that's just a video, right? Y'all know that's not... That's not their real life, right? You know what I'm saying? You know that's entertainment, right? Feel me? Like, man to man, you know that's entertainment, right? I'm being serious. That's not real. The girls in the videos ain't even real. Like, come on. So if you take that imagery and you idolize that, and then you sit there and say, like, okay, I got a girl, I got this girl, I got that girl, and I got my kids, and this, that. Like, you creating a bunch of drama for yourself, B. What's up? You wasting money. You ain't making money. You wasting money. Why? Because you got to take care of this girl. Because you got to take care of that girl. Then you got to take care of your three kids with that, on top of that. What's up? What logic is in that, yo? What's the logic or whatever in having a bunch of females or whatever that you got to take care of, and then you got to hide the fact or whatever that you got this girl and that girl? What you, what we, 15, 16? Come on, man. And even at that age or whatever, it's stupid. I'm keeping it G, man. Like, listen, yo, like, there's no, in my personal opinion or whatever, I just don't get it. I don't get it. Now, am I perfect? No, I ain't no perfect saint, man. I've done my dirt in the past or whatever. You know what I'm saying? But my point is that I learned from, like, yo, man, like, that's not me. That's not me. That's not me. I mean, of course, I wasn't never dating two girls at the same time or nothing like that. And, like, I wasn't tripping. You know what I'm saying? But what I'm saying is, yo, is that there has to be a line that's drawn, yo. What you gonna be 60, 70 years old or whatever, still trying to, like, go to the club, still trying to, like, get with this girl and get with that girl? Come on, man, for real. Then when we gonna put that to the side? You know what I'm saying? While you out here, you know, doing your dirt, trying to be with other women, you know what I'm saying? It's mugs out here or whatever that's trying to create wealth for their children. It's mugs out here trying to create a impactful lineage or whatever for their kids. So that when they die, that their kids at least have something to go off of. That's what men do. That's what men do. I was watching a video the other day, and my man Grant Cardone, he was like, listen, yo, I told my wife Elena what to do in case something happens to me. And if you don't know who Grant Cardone is, all right, Grant Cardone, he controls about $1.5 billion worth of real estate here in America or anywhere else in the world or whatever. I don't know. The man or whatever got crazy bread. And this is not about the money, right? The man said, listen, if something happens to me, tells his wife, dump the house, sell it. Whatever you gotta do, don't keep that. They got a Gulfstream jet. Get rid of the jet. You don't need that. And so it's gonna be a waste. The reason why he got it now, or whatever, is for business purposes. So he can make different deals around the world quickly. We're talking about building wealth here. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, yo, homie got $1.5 billion in real estate. He's got daughters who technically don't ever have to work ever again, and until God says come home, you know what I'm saying, to the world, that real estate is going to be there forever and ever and ever until God shut the lights off. So that's money coming into their family forever and ever. But then you got dudes in the hood that's sitting here in, like, and not just in the hood, just anywhere in the world, that think that they could just have any woman that they want because they don't have an example at home. They never had an example or whatever with from a father. They never had an example of a man. They don't even know God like that, yo. Like, yo, there's a problem. There's a problem. Man, let's dead this. Let's break this curse. Let's break this curse. You tag somebody right now in this video and let's break this curse. Because if you need somebody to talk to, holler at me. Because I don't want to see any more men defeated. I'm not trying to see any more men defeated. I'm trying to see leaders. I'm trying to see winners. I'm trying to see men leading their families or whatever the right way. I'm trying to see men leading their business the right way. I'm trying to see men leading the way where God wants them to lead the right way, man. Come on, man. You ain't listen, you got today. You ain't even got tomorrow. You got right now. Right now, somebody's wife is at home crying and praying for their man to get their thing together, yo. Somebody right now is crying for their man because they need their man. Because a woman needs a man. That's what she want, man. At home at night, the first necessity of a woman, security. And when a woman is not secure and she gotta raise men, how's she gonna raise? Come on, y'all. She gotta raise men? That's your job. She gave birth. Come on. So you want her to give birth and you want her to raise men. All you want to do is go ahead and get busy and do your thing. What type of logic is that? What kind of man is that? That's not a man. That's still a little boy. Don't listen. And if you get offended or whatever, if you're getting offended by this, good. Good. Because somebody needs to rub you the right way. You know what I'm saying? We gotta rub you the right way. And I don't mean anything like weird by that. I don't mean nothing weird by that. I'm telling you straight up and down, yo. Man to man, yo. Let's do this. Let's stop playing around, man. Let's take care of our families, man. So what you live in a hood? So what you only make $35,000-$40,000 a year? Alright. But find a way. That's what men do. Find a way. You ain't got time for the nonsense. You know what I'm saying? And I get it. Shorty may be getting on your nerves, right? Wifey may be getting on your nerves, right? She may be getting under your skin, right? Well, let me ask you a question. Look at yourself in the mirror. Why is she actually getting on your nerves? Why is she pouncing on you like that? Why? Ask yourself that question. See, a lot of times we don't want to deal with it. We don't want to deal with the question. Ask yourself the question, why is she pouncing on you? What am I doing wrong? Take accountability, man. Take accountability. Anytime me and my wife get into it or whatever, I sit back and I'm like, all right, what did I do wrong? Don't get it twisted or whatever, you know what I'm saying? Just because we on here and I post positivity on social media all the time, yeah, absolutely. But there come times or whatever where me and Josie or whatever where we have disagreements. It's natural. It's natural, but we get past it. First thing I do, I look at myself in the mirror. What did I do wrong? I gotta reevaluate myself. See, a lot of us, we don't wanna reevaluate. We don't want to reevaluate. Listen, if you're not going to sit here or whatever, and you're going to be that dude, and you're going to go out into the world, and you want to be with a bunch of women, don't get married. Simple. Don't. Now, some people got different beliefs or whatever. I'm just telling you from what I know and the truth that I know. Now, you could take it or leave it. But the fact is or whatever is that if you're hurting her, the one that you love, the one that you chose, the one that you chose to say I do to, if you're hurting her, you have a problem. You have a problem. Again, if she getting on you, if she pouncing on you or whatever, well, why? Is she not secure? Is she not secure? 9 times out of 10, she's probably not secure. 9 times out of 10, you not doing your job. Because I'm pretty sure there are women out there that support their man tooth and nail, even making $45,000 a year, even making $60,000 a year. And that's not even a lot of money nowadays. It's not a lot of money at all. When you really think about it. You know what I'm saying? You consider like a middle class family, you know what I'm saying? And technically, that's still poor. It's like levels to poorness. My point is that you guys have to sit here and make a decision. men, let's make a decision. Either we going to sit there and we're going to continue to idolize these hip-hop artists and the things that they truly don't have in life and be like, yeah, I want that, I want that, I want that. And then you out in the club every single week, popping bottles, getting drunk, destroying your body while your kids is at home wondering where you at because you want to go be a party animal. Because you still think that you in college. Because you still think that you a senior in high school. You think it's senior week or whatever. So you think you can go out and do those things. So you want to go ahead and you want to do that. Or you see the baby. Or you see, Lil Uzi or whoever. You know what I'm saying? They got a bunch of girls or whatever in their videos and stuff like that. You see all of that. That's the life that you want. Some of these men or whatever, I guarantee you, some of these rappers or whatever out here, they do this stuff because number one, it gets them paid because you gonna watch it. And they do it because they gotta feed their family and that's all they know. They don't be doing this or whatever because they really, really want to. Some of them do, yeah. But I guarantee you, it's a good amount of people that sit there and do it and they sit there and destroy their morals or whatever just so that they can pay their fees or whatever for their child. They get rid of their morals just so they can feed their family. They getting rid of their morals just so they can feed themselves. Come on, man. You think they want to? I don't think so. I don't think so. I would love to have a conversation or whatever with some of these people and get down to the nitty gritty. You do this why? Because it sells. You do this why? Because, you know, that's the enemy's work right there or whatever. So you just going to sell your soul or whatever just so you can get paid and everything to feed your daughter. Because at the end of the day, you ain't got nothing else because you ain't had nobody to help you and guide you. Maybe a young man's father passed away early and he ain't had no guidance. What you expect them to do, right? I get it. I understand it. Who else is going to guide them in the right direction? I get it. I understand it. I understand it. But when you get to a certain level, you got a responsibility. And I got a responsibility to pass off this information to you, to that young man that's watching this right here, right now. I'm telling you. Make sure that you got a man that's going to guide you in the right direction. You smart enough. You bright enough. If ain't nobody telling you right now, young man, you a king. You ain't got to fall down into the trap. You ain't got to fall down into what the enemy wants you to do. You a king. To the man right now that's fighting back and forth, going from, you know, this woman to that woman, got his wife and kids at home. Let me tell you something. There's a man in the Bible named David. One of the greatest warriors ever. The chosen one, the anointed one. One mistake messed up his entire life. One mistake messed up his entire life. He's on the front line battling with his army all the time, winning battle after battle after battle. One of the greatest kings ever. One day he says, yo, I'm a chill. I'm gonna fall back. Y'all go ahead and fight this battle. I'm good. Y'all go fight this battle today. What does he do? He's out. He's looking out the window. He sees a woman. Her name is Bathsheba. When he sees Bathsheba in the lake, naked, he's like, yo, who's shorty? I'm paraphrasing. But he's like, yo, who's shorty? He's like, I need that right there. I need that. That's Bathsheba. Bring her to me. And you can't deny the king. Back then, you couldn't deny the king. If you deny the king or whatever, then you pretty much gone. Sleeps with Bathsheba. Slept with her. The crazy part is, that's his man's wife. That's his man's wife. His homie was in the army fighting for his kingdom while he's sitting here sleeping with his wife. Some people just didn't want to put away childish ways. Not only that, he got her pregnant. he got Bathsheba pregnant. That's when everything hit the fan and he tried to cover up the lie. Let me tell you something. You continue to cover up these lies, they're going to show. They're going to show. And it could hurt your family for generations to come. One mistake. What happened? What'd he do? Yo, tell Bathsheba's husband. Bring him off. Bring him off. Tell him to come home. Tell him to stop fighting. Tell him to come home. He tries to get him to sleep with his wife. And he was like, nah, if the king ain't fighting, I ain't fighting. King, you tired? You good? I ain't gonna fight. I'm straight. Why can't, he said, how can I sit here and be sleeping with my wife when my king is not fighting right now, when my king is chilling right now? Nah, I ain't gonna do that. That's his man. That's his man. So he says, shoot, now I gotta do something. I gotta kill him. Because they're gonna find out. And if you find out that I impregnated your wife, how's that gonna look on the king? Sends Bathsheba's husband back out onto the battlefield, on the front line. And when you're on the front line, it's pretty much a wrap. Set him up to get killed. Done. And then after that, what happened? God was disappointed in David. Now, of course, he repented. And he took his punishment like a man. But the fact is, he didn't have to go through all that. He had turmoil inside his house. Brothers doing things to his sisters that shouldn't be. You can go read it for yourself. My point is, men, generation after generation after generation, David was facing turmoil inside of his home. Now you can sit here and you can be like David and continue to do the things that you do. Or you could be a solid man, the man who God truly made you out to be. And you can go and you can lead your family to success. Maybe you're not going to be the millionaire. That's okay. Maybe you're not going to be the billionaire. That's okay. You are who God says you are. And God says you are a king. So be that king. Be that man. Raise that son. Raise that daughter. Raise that family. I'd rather have a great name than millions of dollars any day. I said I'd rather have a great name than millions of dollars anyway. Because my name is going to last more than money. Period. Period. So continue, man. My man, you ain't even got to do it no more. I'm talking to you. Put the side chicks to the side and leave them on the side. Let them go. You don't need that. You got a wife at home? That's what you need. Build with that. Build your empire with her. The one that's been riding with you since sixth grade. Yeah. Ride with her. Because she ain't going to leave you. That's what you do. That's what you do. I love you, man. This ain't no indictment on you. I'm just here to encourage you and empower you, man to man. And I pray that this applies to the women as well, too. And if you in the role reverse, leave them other dudes to the side. Go with that man or whatever that's been riding with you. I hope everybody understands. One love, you know what I'm saying? It's your boy Kenny Clutch. On the Clutch Vision Podcast.
I'm all about the good vibes, we about to have a good time, leave my problems all behind, we living out the good life, yeah.